Hello everyone, my name is Lovehard on Flippy and welcome back to Half-Life 2. And yes, I have a head cap on my head. So yeah. Yeah, this is another post commentary because I screwed up this recording as well. What I'm supposed to do in this mission is we found Eli. And then we're gonna find like a way out of here with a super portal or something. But yeah. Also, in the previous episode, I talked a little bit about the G-Man, what he was capable of or something. Like I said, he was. Oh wait. Yes, she is opening the door for me. Like I was said, I was talking about a little bit about the, god damn it. Like I was telling a little bit about the G-Man. Like, and he's capable of like a manipulated time and teleport you or something and put you in stasis. And I also talked a little bit about events in Half-Life 1 that started this all. About the Resonant Cascade. Or also known as the Black Mesa incident. But yeah. Damn. Okay, I've got an idea. And G-Man we're watching it from the very beginning, from the start of Half-Life 1 pretty much. But yeah. Like, and I think I'm gonna encounter some zombies soon. And yeah, and there are some headcrabs. But yeah. And also there's a very hard part coming up soon in this map. So I actually died a lot in this one. So, but you're gonna see that once I get there. And also, there's a bunch of fast headcrabs in this area. Like, and I think one of them will activate that trip mine. And yeah, I'm also struggling with the controls again. Oh no, it was a thing. That barrel. These faster crafts are pretty annoying because they are actually pretty fast and then they jump pretty rapid at you. And without armor, red craft deals 10 damage, which is a lot if you get that repeatedly. And there's some turrets here, but I'm gonna go to that area later on with that supply box. But oh, that sucks that my voice doesn't record in these videos. Like, after that, I got one more to do, and then I think I got things right then. Also, there's a little fight coming up with some combine. I think there's at least one shotgun guy. And there's a shotgun guy, and he's pretty deadly. And he killed one of the allies. I think that shotgun guy kills himself, and there's a grenade guy that shoots a grenade with SMG, which also almost killed me. I got like 4 HP left, but you can see it's regenerating slowly up to 20. But yeah, those combined shotguns are really annoying. Again, there's a few turrets here. They didn't even knock out both, and they just got moved a little bit. But yeah, just knock them over and they will deactivate. Oh, I almost died again. Like those are really deadly. Those combined soldiers are really deadly. Even though they use like the basic SMG, they deal so much damage. Ik was hoping they would come through. And that's a grenade. Like, and a pulse rifle is a little bit more effective against them. But it also has lesser ammo. Like, you got only two spare clips with this weapon. Which you have in total like 90 shots with this thing. But it deals also more damage against soldiers. This pulse rifle, which is a pretty cool looking weapon. This weapon is definitely made by the Combine, it's not human structure. Or architect, or whatever. And I missed the grenade horribly. I think I threw it to that other hallway, other doorway, you see. Yes, and you're supposed to throw a grenade in it to make the plug go loose, so that will disable the force field that you can then you can proceed. Just pick up the turret and smash it. That's funny. And I think that's the area with that little supply crate. And they actually never stop shooting for some reason because I'm hiding behind those barrels. But I guess you can still see me through those barrels. And it was just a plasma bullet for the AR2. So there's a load. There is a little load screen coming up in this area to load like more of the map. Like the way this game works, it's like divided into small maps. And it's like you get the feel you're playing like a huge map, but the game actually loads like a small portion of the map every once in a while. That's which is why these load screens are there. And also this is the area I need to defend, but this one isn't really that hard. The only thing you need to watch out for is like a shotgun combine that rushes your turrets, because they will actually knock them over pretty quickly. But like the soldiers that stays in the back, turrets can easily deal with. So I'm just setting up one on each side above, so it takes time for the combine to actually rush the turrets. And I can see them coming a little bit easier. Luckily this game gives you some turrets that were on your side. I don't know how else you're supposed to do this with that many combine soldiers. So I'm gonna have to hold out this scene, or this area for a few minutes, I guess, until Alex comes. But yeah, it's not that hard. The only thing you need, like I said, the only thing you need to watch out for is shotgun combine. Like, some of them will rush and some of them don't rush. Some of them just barely stand there and shoot the turrets, and that isn't really doing anything. So I barely have to do anything, actually. Only watch out for combine rushes. Because I guess the turrets can't really hit moving targets that well, instead. Or the turret is targeting someone else. And phone, shut up. Like, that shotgun's going to rush. And he actually almost killed me. Like, you saw how much HP I got. I got like 80, and it brings me all the way back to 40 with one shotgun blast. Like, and I think it uses like the double barreled feature of the shotgun, which I don't really know how that works for the past 12, but so well, in this game it works somehow, even though the shotgun has one barrel. Like, as past 12 don't have two barrels to shoot, but yeah. I guess it did that to kill enemies a little bit quicker if they are close with the shotgun. But the shotgun is actually pretty effective in range. It's actually quite a. It actually has a quite long range for a shotgun. But it doesn't usually kill like combine in one shot, at least on hard difficulty. Near some of my man axe, but you can easily deal with it with a gravity gun. The gravity gun is probably the best weapon to deal with man axe. And the guy almost knocked down my turret. But Alex will soon come. I hope so. Yeah, there she is. And there's still a lot of cutscene coming up, so we're gonna be silent for a little bit.
Sorry it took me so long. Glad to see you're okay. Let's see if we can find Lawson. It looks like the station might give me better access. There she is. Wait a minute. How does she...
So yeah, it turns out that Mossman is working with Dr. Breen in a combine. So, about to see more of that later on. Like, not in this video, but a little bit later on, yeah. Because, yeah, Dr. Breen actually wanted to capture Eli, because... Yes, I guess he has a big price tag on his head or something, I don't really know. But he's also hunting down Gordon Freeman with these combined forces. So yeah, but I think there's some zombies coming up, like hardcap zombies. As I just move this debris out of the way. Some ad grabs. Like, I don't remember every single thing I did in this episode, but yeah. I recorded this like a few days ago, and now I'm doing it again, but with a post commentary, so yeah. Oh yeah, this area comes first. Like, this area is kind of like this area plays like the floor's lava. Because its water is electrocuted, and if you touch its water, you will take a lot of damage. Yeah, but another head crab. And another head crab is being eaten by a barnacle. And I accidentally jump off the pipe. Good job, me, I guess. And you can just head crab. And that other one, I got electrocuted, I think. I'm just gonna get rid of this barnacle because his tongue is in the way. And if I hit that tongue, he will drag me upwards and tries to eat me. But yeah, I'm trying to figuring out what to do. Like, it's pretty easy, but somehow I messed it up a little bit. But, yeah. Yes, and that box just breaks for some reason. I don't know, I think I was jumping it on the wrong way or something, that the box just breaks. So instead I'm grabbing this pallet. But for some reason that thing broke as well. And that box just breaks. I guess those break automatically as soon as you touch them, I guess, but I don't know. But yeah, I kind of messed up a little bit in this area. Yeah, and the pallet just breaks as well. Which is weird, I guess, but I think I put it in the wrong way, like upside down, and then it will just breaks. And if you put it in the right way, that thing will not break. Like, yeah, I'm like testing it, that this thing doesn't break, and I was like, okay, this one should be it. And I'm gonna get that other one as well. And I'm gonna make sure that I put it on the right side, so it doesn't break. Yes, and this is how you're actually supposed to do this area. Like making a little like walkway to for you to step on, and then just like crouch jump on that ledge. Oh, here are the zombies. Like you can see those are not dead. Those are like sleeping or something and waiting. And they will get up as soon as you get close to them, or they are getting attacked. But they look pretty disgusting. You can see their body almost completely covered in blood, and the rib cage is ripped open. Yeah, and they are controlled by these headcaps that are sitting on their head. Like, they have a beak that pretty much penetrates your skull and latch into your brain or something to take control. And they put their little feet or like legs into your body, I guess, to get hold of it a little bit tight, so they don't fall off really easily. But oh well. But during the entire transformation process, a human that is affected by the headcap never dies, which is actually more horrifying. And the game just freezes a little bit, but yeah. But even if you're a zombie, you are still alive, and I don't know if you're like unconscious or not, but you can hear them like screaming for help as you put them on fire, and they also randomly scream by being idle. I guess it's a person trying to call out for help that is being affected by the headcrab effects, but who knows. And also, this is a really hard part of the game. I eventually turned this game down on easy, because I was just getting tired of it. I was just dying over and over and over again. And it just sucks. This area just sucks, in my opinion. And then after this area, I put the game back on hard again, because I don't want to get stuck here forever, pretty much. Yeah, the soldiers are coming from four different ways, but you only got three turrets. So I guess you're supposed to like use these turrets to hold one area, or at least to hold the three rays, and then you'll be doing the fourth area. But the turrets get easily knocked down, and if that happens, the gun might is just swarming you. And this takes a little bit of time to defend. And that certain guy is gonna rush one of my turrets. And he barely made it. And those are more shotgun guys, and those are just really annoying. And there's so many shotgun guys in this area, it's not even funny. And sometimes they use the grenades as well to knock down the turrets. And I'm struggling with the controls because I changed the controls a little bit. But that wasn't really working for me, this control scheme. I kind of took a whole lot of damage with those grenades. Yeah, and there's a shotgun guy behind me which almost wrecks me pretty much. Yep, and he just kills me instantly. And this happens for quite a while. Until I switch it to easy, then it's just, yeah. I really don't like the shotgun guys in this game. They're so annoying. They're so annoying. That guy, and it just like, and it just like rush your shotgun really likely, and you can go away. Sorry for that. I didn't understand the message, but oh well. Yeah, there's some medics also coming from time to time, which I used the gravity gun to take care of, but you can see I'm still struggling with the controls scheme I set up for myself, but I ended up changing it back to the default ones. Yeah, I'm pretty getting cornered from every single angle. Yeah, I'm just dying here. Yep, and that guy just smacks me and kills me instantly. Like, I put the stairs in this area as at some point, but that isn't really working as well. Because I was just getting killed over and over and over again. And that guy just hits me through the turret. Like, and I quickly saved the gate because I don't want to get back. And then that buttload of combine coming in out of nowhere. And then I accidentally knocked out both of my turrets. Which means at this point I'm pretty much just screwed. This part is just not even funny. Yep, and a shotgun guy just kills me instantly. And then I killed myself with a grenade because a shotgun guy shot me in the back. Yeah, this is just not funny for me, and this is just not funny anymore. I'm just dying over and over and over again. And I think it's boring to see the part over and over and over again. So, yeah. That's why I switched it just for this part on easy. But damn, this is just annoying. There's still quite some time left on this video, yeah. This is gonna take for a little bit. Yep, and then another guy just kills me instantly. And third, yeah. I'm just panicking because there's two shotgun guys and I was just getting cornered. Oh, this is just ridiculous. I'm getting shot from two sides at the same time with shotguns, and that's really dangerous. Yeah, like the Fallout 5 is a pretty hard game, but this mod is even more, harder than the original game. Like, the original game was not this hard. I guess health regeneration helps a little bit, but it's just not fast enough to keep up with the damage you take. Yep, and then a guy comes and then, yeah, I got shot in the face and dies. Yeah, and this I was like I had it, and I'm gonna switch the game difficulty. Like, I don't care if people mocking me for that I switch difficulties mid game, but I don't care. I just want to move on. I just want to get stuck in this area forever. And it's just it is just not fun to watch me dying over and over and over and over again. And those medics are also really annoying. But for some reason, when I load the game is back on hard. I guess this, maybe the save game was set on hard, and if you don't save after that, then the game is gonna revert back to hard. Like, you can see me later, like, switching multiple times to easy difficulty. Like, the game is now back on hard, pretty much, after I load the save. And yeah, you can see it's back on hard. Like, what I should have done to avoid that is just switch difficulty in a save game, and then the game will never revert back to the previous difficulty you set it on. Which I'm just getting wrecked over and over again, and I didn't even realize at first that the game was keep switching back, because yeah, I didn't know back then. And you can see that shotgun hurts like a bitch. Yeah. And that guy just smacked my toes like nothing. And then I'm dead again. And I was like, fun to calm the fuck on. This is just bullshit. And of course, the guy immediately starts to fire his energy bomb, which almost instantly kills me. And then just, as soon as I pop out, it just instantly kills me. Like, and the game is still on hard, and I thought it wasn't easy. Yeah. I was like, when checking if something was wrong, if something was wrong with the mod configuration, or whatever you can call it. But I was like, well, this is not easy, this doesn't feel like easy, it's still like hard. But yeah, lots of dying in this episode though. Yeah. And the guy just pops up out of nowhere and instantly kills me. And a shotgun guy just instantly kills me if, like, nothing. Yeah, this is just ridiculous. And Yeah, now I realize that the game was on that the whole time. And you can see the difference immediately. I got shot from almost point blank and I took way less damage. And yes, everyone, you can call me a pussy, but I really don't care. I really don't care. I just want to move on. I don't care if people call me a pussy because I switched difficulty in the middle of the game. And now the game is back on hard. Yep, I realized. And I guess I kinda realized it now. Yes. And now the game will never revert back to hard because I saved it right after I switched difficulty. So I was just getting tired of this. Because this was just bullshit. And it also helps that I now can instant kills the combine soldiers with the shotgun from a decent range. And I think this is the part I succeed. I'm just gonna camp in this room and just let the combine come to me. Yes, I know the text is in Dutch, but I don't feel like changing the game settings to get it in English. I don't feel like doing that. And I think by doing that, you're gonna have to re-download a part of the game. And I don't feel like doing that, so that's why it's keeping in Dutch. So if you are Dutch, yeah, it's nice that you can read the text. But you should also have no problems to understand what they are saying, if you can talk English. But for the people who can't talk English and can talk Dutch, I guess you can read the subtitles if a character's talking or something. But look at that thing. The thing is now really effective in with range. And that energy ball is doing funny things. Finally, this part is coming. Get to the like soon. This part is ending really soon. Like, I think right now, this is it, I guess, but damn, this part just takes forever, and now I'm gonna switch it back to hearts. But, yeah. I'm not trying to find Alex, but she's over there. She is over there, I mean.
Sorry to take so long, Gordon. Looks like you could have used some help.
Yeah, no shit.
Again,
but I think I also ended this video, like, right now. I guess. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video and see you guys later. Bye bye.